think every goalie in the NHL, after what happened to Jonathan Quick last night, is going to really be paying a little extra attention. Tough thing for Quick last night. Here's Hurdle again. Oh, does it? He scores again. And what a goal. Wow.
Are you kidding me? Because I want to let that speak for itself.
19 years of age, that's confidence.
That's a high level of skill. I'm speechless, Brett. Speechless.
I got a smile.
Here's Leon Chera. Backhands that back down the ice, and a penalty killing clinic being put on. A Schaefer moves in shorthanded, chips it around Turco, and scores! What a goal by Peter Schaefer, shorthanded.
Here's the speed we were alluding to, Peter Schaefer, and look at Turco, he's stuck in no man's land. What a creative play by Peter Schaefer.
What
a
goal by Peter Schaefer.
That's outstanding. That is just a beautiful goal.
Dumped out. Now picked up by Ovechkin. Here he comes. Ovechkin trying to drag it through him there.
Oh!
He scored! Alexander Ovechkin, when it looked like it was no longer possible, he still got it done.
Holy jumping, you have got to be kidding me. We have seen some great young goals, and even Wayne Gretzky's looking up on the overhead scoreboard to just take a second look. His tongue's hanging like Michael Jordan. He drags it to the inside, to the backhand. On his back, one hand on his stick, and he corrals it with the hook of his blade right here and fires it into the open side. That is great stuff. Oh, we can't see this enough. I mean, we can because it's against the Phoenix Coyotes, but that is something spectacular. That is special.
To a couple of their forwards near the end of the season.
Yeah, Tarasenko and Steen were out for 5 and 6 games at the end of the season, and he liked the way the new lines were playing.
Lead pass for Tarasenko. He breaks free to the backhand. He scores! Oh, my, the same move he used at Madison Square Garden back in November. He does it again against Dubnyk. It is a 5-1 lead.
But his ability at high speed to make this move, he fends off both players, fakes like he's going to one side, and then the Peter Forsberg move that Forsberg made famous in the Olympics years ago, went, reaches all the way back to the free hand and stuffs it in on the far side. And you have to do that a long ways away because of the long legs of Devan Dubnyk, who's 6 feet 6 inches tall. What a move by Tarasenko.
Guy Boucher, he's loaded up here. He went LeCavalier, St. Louis, and Stamkos.
And Marty St. Louis in the top of the third. He spins, waits. Is that a good goal? They say it is. Corey Crawford again asking about did that puck continue to advance to the net?
Well, we saw Pierre-Marc Bouchard make a play like this a couple of years ago on Nikolai Haby-Boulin. But St. Louis, looks like he's going to shoot out a backhand. He waits a second longer. That forces Corey Crawford to go down and crossbar and in.
Early on to just getting control of the puck. Kept his legs moving to make sure that he kept that 2-on-1.
There's Daniel, what a goal! Patrick Daniel Sedin, what a beauty!
By the Vancouver Canucks. What a tip pass by Henrik Sedin, and then just magic. I mean, this
this is like an exhibition right now. They're having so much fun. Look at that no-look tip by Hedrick. He knew exactly where Daniel was going to be. A great anticipation by Mika Kiprusoff. He tries for the poke check, but it's just too quick. The between the legs and up and over. A career high for Daniel.
It plays a lot more lopsided. Salvador's blast. Griffith taking it in the body. Tries to split the D. Keeps battling against Zielinski. And he scores! An impossible goal! The little engine that could. Seth Griffith.
That's with a shot block. Recognition. I get a chance to potentially split the D. And he just stays with it. And how about that? A little chip backhand through the legs with his back to the net. Right through Corey Schneider. That's a save you got to have if you're the Devils goaltender. Not going to take anything away from Seth Griffith. But in a game where you got it 2-2, you got the momentum on your side, you need your goaltender to come up with that puck. But what an effort. And what a highlight reel goal by Seth Griffith. Shane looks, he's got a Ginla as an option, fired it on goal, rebound came out, McGinn was there but couldn't get to it, and now a foot race, Subban out of the box and into the play, he'll come around, Subban, waves, scores, what a goal! He gets the crowd something to talk about, and they will, look at this!
P.K. Subban, he knows when the big moments are coming. He explodes out of the box, recognizing the chance. Look at the finish. He wants it right now. He's giving the beaver tail, slapping the puck. He wants it. And then, what poise and patience. Barry goes down. A hard sell to the backhand and finish.
Riley Nash. Nash, Semmons in. He'll delay it. Rolls in on Bachman. Semmons taken down. They score on the follow-up. Good work by Alexander Semin. And the Hurricanes get a fortuitous bounce and get on the score.
Carlson collects the puck for the Sharks. Thornton to Carlson. Back to Thornton. Here's Irwin with a drive. That deflected over top of the goal. Puck comes right out in front. And they score! With his back to the goal on his knees, Melker Carlson makes it 2-0.
Shots tip, goes up and almost hits Markstrom in the back. And Carlson just hooks it around and gets it to go. Wow, what a play. Dan Hamhuis has him pinned, and Carlson's able to get it. There, here's the shots deflected by Pavelski. Goes to Carlson, he kicks it around. And then with Radim Verbata coming back, Carlson's able to hook it into the net.
Side to Getzlaff. Getzlaff, cross ice pass to Ryan, or to Bobby Smith, looking for the hat trick. He scores! What a move he made, and Bobby's Ryan gets the hat trick and ties the game at 3-3.
Wow. You talk about confidence. And again, the Kings are on their heels. This play starts in the neutral zone with just a long cross-ice pass. Getzlaff all the way across to Ryan, but then Ryan schooled one of the Kings' defensemen. Here's Getzlaff. He looked up before he made the pass. Now it's a one-on-one. Harold gets beat on the spin. Then the goaltender quick gets beat on the poke. And Bobby Ryan has a hat trick. The hats are all over Staples Center ice. The spin, the move, the composure to go back to the middle on the forehand. You're not going to see many prettier. Now, if you're a Kings player, you got to put that man to the outside and then quick. The goaltender did not understand. Watch the poke. The stick will come forward, but then you're a little off balance. You miss. When you go with a poke, many times it's all or nothing. So the defense breaks down one-on-one. The goaltender gets caught deep in his...